Be Wealthy and Smart, episode 662.
Into a world of wealth and financial freedom without budgets, boredom, or bosses on Be Wealthy and Smart. And now, here's your host, Linda P. Jones.
Welcome to Be Wealthy and Smart. I'm Linda P. Jones, America's Wealth Mentor, empowering women and men worldwide to financial freedom. Well, first I want to say Happy New Year. If you're listening to this, that means it's 2020, and I want to be the first or one of the first to wish you Happy New Year. I hope you had a good celebration last night and you are excited about the year ahead. I know I am. There's so many things coming. The market looks like it's going to be amazing. If you listen to my last podcast, you know exactly why I feel that way and why we could be repeating the roaring 20s. How exciting is that? Today, what I want to talk to you about is how to get 2020 off to a good start. Because I know you've got all those resolutions, you're thinking about starting fresh, starting over, all the things you wish you had done last year that you want to do better this year. And I know that money or finance or paying off debt or something financial is probably on that list. So let's talk about five ways you can get 2020 off to a good start. The first thing I want you to do is write down your goals, because it helps to really start from a dreaming perspective. I want you to think big and think about what you want to accomplish in 2020. Think about what are the possibilities for you and maybe stretch your goals a little bit. What is it that maybe you didn't accomplish last year that you really want to tackle this year? Whether that's saving more money, whether that's contributing to your 401k or enough to get the match or enough to max it out, whether that is starting a Roth IRA or, if you make too much money, a traditional IRA, perhaps saving for a down payment or buying a new home or a second home. Maybe it's time to replace the car and you're looking at options there and what you should be doing. You might also be planning a big trip. Or you might have a special occasion, like a special anniversary or birthday milestone. And obviously, if you have debt, that is at the top of your list. But I want you to think about the possibilities. I want you to dream from a perspective of what if? What if I could accomplish this? What if this would be a year that I could get this done? What if this is the year that I can check this off of my list that I've had on there for a long time? So I want you to first just write down your list of possibilities, your list of things that you want to accomplish this year. Put it all out there, put it on paper so you can take a look at it. The second thing I want you to do is attack debt with a vengeance. If you have credit card debt, that has to be at the top of your list, because many of those interest rates are just ridiculous. They're 24%, 20%, 16%, all kinds of incredibly terrible interest rates. So I want you to put credit card debt at the top of your list for getting rid of this year. You may also have student loans that you're working on. These are things that you definitely want to get rid of. You want to attack with a vengeance. You want to really go after this year, because this is keeping you from moving forward. It's keeping you from building wealth, because you're starting from a place of being underwater. And so you have to come back to level or to stability before you can really start to invest. So I want you to find a way to think about how you can get rid of this debt that's around your neck. And if you haven't studied my debt diamond method, I suggest you listen to podcast number 430, because I disagree with the concept of paying off your smallest balances and ignoring interest rates. It makes no sense to me that for every $10,000 you're in debt and you have one interest rate at 12%, that's a smaller balance than another balance at 24%, that you're going to ignore the 24% and pay off the 12% balance. That makes no sense to me whatsoever. So I think you should pay attention to the interest rates on your debt and tackle the highest interest rate first. That is going to be the least expensive way to pay off your debt. And that's what the debt diamond method is all about. It's the most valuable method to dump your debt. It pays off your debt cheaper and improves your credit faster and at the same time that you're paying off your debt. So check that out in podcast 430 if you haven't listened to my debt diamond method yet. Many people have used it, swear by it, love it. I've gotten lots of thank yous and I know it has helped many, many people and it will work for you. Number three. When you look at that list that you created in step number one, there were some bigger expenses there. There were some things that are going to probably cost thousands of dollars, whether that's a down payment on a home or whether that's a big trip that you're taking or something else. So I want you to create a plan to start saving for that big expenditure this year. I want you to save the money before you do the thing. So don't put the trip on the credit card and then be paying the credit card off for a year or two. I want you to start saving for the trip before you go. So work out how you can plan and save for your bigger expenses that are coming up and start doing that right now. Number four. I want you to get really serious about your investments and double down if you can. That means come up with more to contribute to your 401k, or if you've maxed out your 401k, open up a regular brokerage account and start another investing account. You can never be investing too much money, and the earlier that you start, the easier that it is. Now, this year, the S&P 500 was up 28%, which is phenomenal. And in the VIP experience, we had investments up much more than that, even up to 40%. When you have a big up year, like the S&P 500 being up 28%, what happens the following year? Well, there have been statistics showing the data on what happens the following year. And it so happens that the following year is usually a good year too. That's right, 10 out of 12 times the following year has a positive year as well. And the average that it's been up is 15.2%. So while we're still going to have ups and downs, I'm not saying that we're not going to have pullbacks and corrections. I'm not saying that it's going to be a smooth, straight line up. We are going to have times when the market goes down, and when it goes down and it's scary, that will happen during the year. But I do think by the end of the year, this time next year, we will likely be up around 15%. That's my 2020 prediction. So get invested. Don't be sitting in cash at a 1% interest rate. I want you to get your money invested. Figure out your asset allocation. If you haven't looked at that yet, I've got podcasts about asset allocation, or you can come into the VIP experience where you get an asset allocation model and I tell you exactly where you need to be investing and what you need to be investing in. And number five, I want you to review what you did well and not well this year and write that in your wealth journal. It's really good to examine the last year, to take a look at it, say what maybe you wish you had done better, and say what you did really well, because chances are it wasn't all one way or the other. You had some good things that happened financially and maybe some not so good things that happened financially, but you probably had some of both. So why don't you write that down in your wealth journal and pat yourself on the back for the good things and promise to do better on the things that didn't go so well. I want you to also create your positive affirmations or your positive statements that you're going to use going forward and create 2, 3, maybe 5 or up to 10 positive statements and say them as if they're already true. And then put already true statements in between each sentence, like I always teach you, and just repeat those. Repeat those morning, noon, and night. First thing when you wake up, last thing before you go to bed. And you'll find that miraculously, those things do start to come true. So write down those already true statements in your wealth journal, start focusing on that, and that's going to get you off to a great start for 2020. Now, I have something exciting to share with you, and that is the results of our review contest that we've been having. That's right, we had the Holiday Sizzle Review Contest for the podcast and also for the Wealth Heiress book reviews. So thank you to everyone who wrote a review. From the bottom of my heart, I so appreciate each and every review. I read them all, and some of the things that are said in the review just astound me, amaze me, tickle me sometimes, and mostly make me proud that you're doing great, that you're taking action, that you're making progress, that you're learning things, and that I've helped you see things in maybe a new and different light than other authors or podcasters have. So thank you for that. I love hearing that message. I love that you love the book and the podcast. I had no idea that people would love it as much as you say you do. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And now I want to introduce our winners because, as you know, we have 20 prizes that are being given away. So many people who wrote a review are getting rewarded today. Here we go. We have 10 of the Wealthy Mindset Blueprint audio sets to give away. This is a $197 program that I still sell on my website for that. And we have 10 people who are winning it for free. It is a digital program, so I'm able to email you a password and you can get in and listen to it at your convenience, and you'll have it forever to be able to listen to again and again, to review perhaps every New Year's. Whatever you want to do, you can use it to remove those limiting beliefs and those blocks and have a wealthier mindset. So here we are. Number one is Jack7207. That's J-A-C-Q 7207. Number two is Roslyn. And I noticed, Roslyn, you're in Canada. R-O-S-L-Y-N. Number three is Rene. Number four is Dude202. Number five is Jack McClafferty. Number six is MP908. Number seven is TOI. Number eight is AnaElia, A-N-A, capital E-L-I-A. Number nine is Adupy, A-D-U-P-Y. And number 10 is KK, also from Canada. So congratulations, you've all won my Wealthy Mindset Blueprint audio sets. And all you need to do is email me at lpjhome@gmail.com. And I'll get that right out to you. And also, there is a link in the show notes that has my email address. So if you're driving or walking and you can't write it down right now, it is in the show notes. So you can just find my address in the show notes and send me an email. All right, I have five of the Wealth Heiress books to give away. Number one, Mack in New Jersey, NJ. Mack in NJ. Number two, Jessica in LA. Number three, Red 45KG. Number four, AvaLi, A-V-A-L-I. And number five, Jlynnballet, J-L-Y-N-N-B-A-L-L-E-T. Congratulations, you won five of my You're Already a Wealth Heiress, Now Think and Act Like One, Six Practical Steps to Make It a Reality Now book. As you know, it was named one of the best wealth books of all time by Book Authority. So I will get that right out to you. Just email me, let me know you won the book, and I'll send it off to you. And I'd be happy to personalize it. Let me know who you want me to sign it to, and I will certainly autograph it for you as well. All right, and now we have five one-on-one wealth mentoring sessions with me. The first winner is Eileen, and in parentheses, you had ETC. The second winner is Danielle C. The third winner is Manasi Chaubal, M-A-N-A-S-I-C-H-A-U-B-A-L. Number four is TangoRom, T-A-N-G-O-R-O-M. Number five is Katpre-CPA, Katpre-CPA. Congratulations, you've won a one-on-one wealth mentoring session with me. Again, please send me an email, let me know that you've won, and we'll set up a convenient time to talk. So congratulations to all the winners, and once again, thank you to everyone who wrote a review. If this is your year to learn where wealth building opportunities are and increase your investing knowledge, skills, and confidence without complexity and without overwhelm, check out the VIP experience right on the homepage of my website at lyndapjones.com. Right now is a great time because I have a special offer that's going to be the lowest price all year. So if you've been thinking about joining, now's the time. Just go to the homepage of my website, click on What is the VIP Experience, and it'll tell you all about it and give you a sneak peek inside as well. Well, I'm excited for 2020. I hope that you'll stay with me on this journey this year. We'll be there together, headed through the ups and downs, the thicks and thins, and we'll just see what this year has to bring. I know there will be challenges. I know there will be some really great times too, but I really think that over the year, we will be well rewarded for keeping our eye on the long term, at staying invested, and being the good investors that we are. That's all for today. Until next time, live the good life and be wealthy and smart.
Thank you for listening to Be Wealthy and Smart with Linda P. Jones. Share the wealth and tell your family and friends about the show. Check out our website, blog, and social media for more riches at www.bewealthyandsmart.com.